What is good, everybody? Welcome to an Epic My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have a brand new 2-in-1 WWE Elite review, and it is on the brand new Elite Series 83 Edge and Trash Corbin figures. But before we get into it, guys, I do want to address the Brody Lee slash Luke Harper situation. If you guys did not know Luke Harper or Brody Lee, his real name is John Huber. But if you guys did not know, I believe it was last night or it may have been early yesterday, but he did pass away due to lung disease. I don't know the exact specifics of it. I just know it was a lung disorder or a disease. And I wanted to send my deepest condolences to the Huber family, to anybody that worked with him, any close friends to him, man. It really is awful, and it is very tragic news. It broke my heart to learn that news yesterday, and I wanted to send my prayers and my condolences to that family and just keep them in your thoughts and prayers, man. And it is a very sad situation. I absolutely hate it. I love Luke Harper, Brody Lee. John himself was a hilarious. Any videos or interviews or anything I ever saw of him was great. I was always a big fan of Harper, loved Brody Lee's character, and it was just so cool to see him go from WWE and what he did with the Wyatt family and then the single stuff, and then when he got over to AEW when he finally left the company. Always enjoyed his work, and I will also continue to use him in the pick fed because I want to honor him and his memory. So we will continue to use Luke Harper in our pick fed with the Wyatt cult for now. We don't know if he'll break off into singles action, who knows, but we will continue to use Luke Harper, and I just wanted to get that out of the way. But I was saddened by that news. I'm still just thinking about it over and over again, but I do want to honor him in today's video, and I wanted to also show support to his family in this time. Thought he was fantastic. We'll always think he's fantastic. So let's get back into our review here and talk about what he completely loved to do, and that is professional wrestling, specifically wrestling figures. Here today we have the brand new Elite 83 Edge and Trash Corbin figures. Guys, as you guys can see here in our front viewing window, we finally have an updated Edge. We've been waiting on this forever. We got an updated Trash, so we're gonna compare that and see what's up with that. But we got images of Edge and Trash on the side there. On the back, you have an image from WrestleMania 36 where Edge took on Orton. You got Trash right there. You got some bio reads. If you want to read them, you can pause it now. You got two images of them, the same as the back image right there. And that pretty much does it for our packaging for Edge and Trash Corbin, guys. So with that being said, let's dive in and crack Edge and Corbin out of their packaging. Alright guys, so here is Edge and Trash out of the packaging, looking, you know, pretty freaking football swell. You know, I'm not gonna BS with you here. I'm pretty impressed with what we got going on so far with these figures. We won't know the full details though unless we dive into the figures and find out what the hell both of them are about. There are some nitpicks about them, and there are some problems with them that we will get into, of course, and show them all to you guys and showcase it all. But with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and dive into Trash Corbin's accessories and then Trash Corbin, and then we will run it back and take a closer look at Edge's accessories and Edge. So that being said, guys, let's go ahead and get into it. So starting out with Corbin's accessories, guys, you do have his effing clobe. You have his robe, or his cape, if you will. As you guys can see, we've seen this before with guys like Wade Barrett. We've seen this before, I'm pretty sure, with like Harley Race. We've seen this before with other guys like that. And it's basically just brown and white stripes right here. You got some nice fur detail sculpted in here, but it is definitely one solid piece of rubber that I don't know a lot of people are going to be excited about. But if you guys want to drape this over the shoulders, you of course can. Just take the figure, drape it over the shoulders right there and put him on display, or walk around. I bet you could walk around a little bit. You just couldn't move the arms. But, you know, it's solid. He's King Trash. He has to have his signature cape clobe, you know. Next up, guys, we do have the scepter. You have this black scepter, which is kind of bent, as you guys can see. So out of the packaging, it is a little bit warped right here. You could fix that, but it's kind of wobbly-dobbly. It's not stiff by any means. It's soft material. It's in solid black. You got some good sculpts and stuff like that going on. You could hit people in the skull with it, bust them open, use this as a weapon, something like that. But I think that's pretty nice. You like to see the scepter right there. This little piece right here clips on the front, so you guys can see right here, this will pretty much just plug in on the front of the cape, and you'll just plug that in, and that'll be the front little locking piece, so you guys can get it on the thing. I don't know why you wouldn't just make it where one side came unplugged, I guess, so you could have both out and it just chill there. But wouldn't it make sense to just be one-sided? That way you don't have to keep up with this little plug-in piece. I don't know. You also have his crown accessory, which I think is pretty nice. The colors and the sculpt going on with this, with the gold and the crown spikes and everything. It's more of a soft rubber. It's not like stiff, or it won't stab you or anything, so that's pretty cool. It fits on the figure pretty damn well, if I do say so myself. So right there, you guys can see that. The bald head looks good with the crown on there, so that's pretty nice to see with Trash. And then for interchangeable hands, guys, he comes with these hands. Now, I don't know why he would come with these hands. Maybe somebody can let me know, but it almost is like doorknob twisting hands. Like, it looks like he's twisting a doorknob, and these are, we have seen these before. These came with the Ultimate Edition Finn Balor when they were painted for the Demon, because you guys know he did like this and the teeth were on the back of the hands and he like crossed his arms like this or something and it looked like fangs coming out of the Demon's face. But they used bare like skin tone hands with this Trash Corbin, so I don't know what these are supposed to be for Trash Corbin. He should have came with like the Ricochet hands so he could like wave you off like he loves to do. And he's obviously missing the trash can accessory, but you know, maybe on the next release. But that pretty much does it for Corbin's accessories, guys. So with that being said, let's dive into Corbin himself. So getting into Corbin himself, guys, we have seen this head sculpt before. Not really though, because I think the last time we got it, his hair was like jet black. It was like on that basic figure. I'll pull it up on your screen for you there. I think a lot of people took that figure and then like acetoned off all of the black. I know we did that on Action Figure Surgery. We put the head sculpt on my Trash Corbin figure that I ended up throwing away by accident, but overall the likeness is super there. I think this is a fantastic head sculpt. The baldness, the facial hair, the lip color, the likeness, it looks just like Trash Corbin. This is actually a really, really good head sculpt, so hats off to Mattel for that one. Looks really good. Can't wait to switch this head sculpt out onto a different body, if you get what I'm saying. But going down into the torso, they did use the Dean Ambrose slash Jeff Hardy torso mold, which is definitely too probably like skinny or ripped up or muscular than Trash Corbin. Like Trash Corbin has kind of a pudgy torso, but I understand why they use this. It actually does look nice on the figure. Like it fits the figure really well. It's just not that accurate. It's not completely accurate, which isn't the biggest deal. They've used more ripped up torsos for people before. They've used smaller torsos for people before. But overall, I'm not gonna totally criticize it. You also notice that he has his tattoos underneath his shirt. One thing that I don't like though is I hate how they put his star tattoo over here on this shoulder, but they didn't put the star tattoo on this shoulder when that's clearly supposed to be symmetrical. And I think they should have just left those off and put them like on his shoulders up here. Or if they're gonna put it here, definitely match it on the other side, if you get what I mean. So there's that. He also has Kalisto arms like Matt Riddle. Why does he have Kalisto arms like Matt Riddle? Or these are old Dolph Ziggler arms. The Dolph Ziggler basic arms are what these are. I don't think these are Kalisto arms. I think these are Dolph Ziggler basic arms from back in the day is what it looks like. And his old figures didn't come with that, so I don't know why they did that. I think his old figures had like Bobby Roode arms, like Bobby Roode basic arms. So we'll take a look at that. We'll check that out in the comparison shot, but he does have black wrist tape. All his tattoos and stuff look really good. Going down into the crotch and legs, this is very interesting. At first, I thought this was an Undertaker waist and thighs, but the Undertaker waist and thighs is much larger. So they use like a skinnier mold for the thighs and the black crotch. He is not on ball joints like previous Corbins. Every other Corbin was on ball joints. They decided not to go with the same leg mold. He also has regular lower legs and regular boots. So he doesn't have the tall boot mold. He has regular boots and stuff. It says King Corbin over here with a logo, and then on this side it does say End of Days and everything. But pretty interesting stuff, man. Very interesting stuff, all the things they decided to do with this figure. But that pretty much does it for our Trash Corbin figure, guys. Let's get into some Trash Corbin Elite figure comparisons. So getting into your Trash Corbin Elite figure comparisons, guys, you will see the new Elite 83 here. We have the Elite, was it 57 over here, and then we have the Elite 50 over here. This is a custom shirt I put on here to hold us over, because this was shirtless. This is like his NXT days over here, I'm pretty sure. But you guys can see they literally use three different leg molds, three different calf molds, same boots, three different crotch molds it looks like, and then these two had the same torso and arms and shoulders, different head sculpts that are slightly similar. It's just very weird how they changed all this up. Here is the difference in the arms, so you guys can see what I'm talking about. So you guys can see here are the longer, thicker arms, which I think would look much better on this Elite over here. He doesn't have black wrist tape, but these are Dolph Ziggler basic arms, and these are like the classic like Bobby Roode basic arms, or that's just what I think of. This is that same mold, I'm pretty sure. I can't think of a figure like an Elite that came with those, but this was on ball joints, which is weird, and he had all this detail sculpted on the legs. These are completely different. I know he doesn't have all the bells and whistles on there, but I just think it's very odd that they've used three different formulas almost for all three Corbin Elite figures, which is very crazy to be honest with you. But anyways, guys, that does it for your Elite comparisons for Trash Corbin. So let's go ahead and dive into Edge's accessories. So diving into Edge's accessories, guys, you don't really get a lot, as you guys can see. We'll get into his main accessory, which is like his Return Edge shirt. And you can see by the graphic, it's got the hand skull, like the Rock and Roll Longhorns or Devil Horns hand pose. You got the skull meeting it down. You got roses. You got some lightning bolts. You know, he's the Rated R Superstar, man. He's a rock star. I mean, that's what Edge is, right? You got the Edge logo. It looks good. It's a really good t-shirt. This could fit on not only this Edge, you can put this with his older Edge figures too. I think it fits him perfectly. You can make a promo attire. There's a lot lot of things you can do with this cloth t-shirt. I'm really glad we got this. Also, out of the packaging, he does have mic holding hands, which are always perfect to see. You gotta have mic holding hands. And then this is very, very crazy, to say the least. Okay, so you guys know he's the rock star, right? He does the Longhorn rock and roll hands, right? Does this look like those hands, Brad? Are you noticing what I'm noticing, Brad? Looking like a little bit of a too sweet? So basically, this figure has a running change with it. So if you end up with the version that I have right now, it is actually a more rarer version. It was called a rarer version by Action Figure Attack. It's like a limited figure that basically they accidentally, or they ended up giving him too sweet hands by accident when they're supposed to be the rock and roll hands. And they will have a running change where these hands are changed to the rock and roll hands that we got with his 3-in-1 rated R figure with the Zack Ryder and Curt Hawkins, as you guys know. But what makes this interesting too is this is the first time they've ever given us bare skin tone hands like this without any decos. So without any tape on it, without AJ gloves, without anything like that. These are the first bare hands we've ever gotten that don't have any deco on it, and it was by accident. So if you want to put these on your Finn Balor or any of that, you can totally do that. So there you go. That's pretty cool. I'm kind of glad I got this. Another thing I meant to mention is I'm pretty sure he wore black wrist tape and hand tape, or like black hand tape underneath his gauntlets. So this is supposed to have black going around it, but not the biggest deal. I just wanted to point that out to you guys. So if you guys end up with the too sweet hand version, that is the more rare version, or the, you know, like a little running change there that will be changed in the future. So hold on to that, I guess. I don't know. Or use it for your Finn Balor's or something. But that does it for Edge's accessories, guys. Let's dive into the Rated R Superstar himself. So diving into Edge himself, guys, starting out with our old man Edge head sculpt. This is a really good head sculpt, man. I really like it. I like the hair color. I like the beard color. I think the likeness is there. I like the smile and everything like that. I really would have liked to seen like a determined Edge face. Not like pissed off, but just kind of squinting there, like kind of like a serious face, you know, going into that matchup with WrestleMania, with Randy Orton at WrestleMania. But I still like this head sculpt. I think we're going to get some pretty good head sculpts on his Ultimate Edition that is coming soon as well. So hopefully that will be the case here. So head sculpt looks good. I'm not complaining about that whatsoever. I think that is a really good job there. He has all of his tattoos here. He has the red elbow pads and the red wristbands here, which I'm pretty sure these are I feel like there's some slight inaccuracies here. Nothing that I can think of off the top of my head except for the black hand tape that we're missing. Another thing that I don't like about the figure is the torso choice. Now, I would have loved to seen the Jake the Snake Hall of Fame body for this, simply because he had the ripped up torso. You guys know the Edge put in a lot of work to come back. He was in the best shape of his life. He had the complete six pack going. He had the hairy chest mold. There's no chest hair, no stomach hair or anything. This is the same skinny mold we got with all of our other Edge figures. I think that they could have definitely used a Seth Rollins torso, or maybe a Trash Corbin torso that they used on his last figures. You guys know, with like, it's like a skinny rip. That would have even worked for the taller body mold there, because with this body mold, it kind of makes the torso, like, it's the same thing with Jake the Snake. It's like the torso is too short for the legs or something. It just kind of looks a little bit off. But nonetheless, going down into the tight, another thing that is inaccurate about the attire is the Rated R logo is supposed to be slightly crooked. Again, not a big deal, just pointing out all the things just in case you guys were wondering. Really love the gray color when this figure, or when he first came out in this attire. I really wanted this attire in figure form, so seeing it here is nice. It's like a matte gray on the figure. It looks really good. Rated R Edge logos here. Same thing on this side there. You got the red Rated R knee pads, which look really good. He also has the same lower legs and leg mold for any other Edge Elite. I think there are some slight inaccuracies on the kick pads as well, like D-Freedom 30 pointed those out, but I still like the way they look. I love the maroon color and the gray and the decals that we got going. One thing they definitely left off of the figure is the chrome shoes. I really wanted the chrome shoes on this figure, so I'm going to have to paint that in to make that accurate, because I was really hoping to see the chrome shoes on here. So we will do some surgery on this guy and get him looking the way I'd like. I might switch the torso. We'll have to see about that, how I'm feeling, you know, run it through the gauntlet, see what we got going on. But overall, really, really like the Edge figure. I've been waiting on an updated Edge here ever since he came out at the Rumble. So having this in my possession is great. I really like the figure, but let's get into some Edge Elite figure comparisons. Oh, and hold up. I almost forgot to compare him to Trash Corbin. So here's the official custom Trash Corbin from Fig Skib, and then you have the official Elite 83. I honestly feel like my custom's way more accurate, completely more realistic. The only thing that this one has going for it is obviously the hair, so we'll definitely have to be doing a head swap or something like this, but yeah, there you go. Trash Corbin compared to King. They're both trash, but mine's definitely more accurate. So for your Edge Elite figure comparisons, guys, here is, you got the Elite 8 over here. Sorry about that. You got the Target Hall of Fame edition with a torso swap. You have the new Elite 83, and then you have the brand new ringside exclusive 3-in-1 Edge Heads Edge, and all of them look pretty good. I think that this torso mold works better for a back in the day Edge. Like, I think this is more accurate It's more beefy. It's got like a slight definition there, but it's got like more of a broad chest. I mean, the man's 240 pounds, 220, 30, 40 pounds back in the day, and I think that it would work better for him to have a beefier chest mold, look a little bit better there, but definitely need to switch out this torso. I like the way all these look up next to each other. Looking pretty damn cool how we got it all set up right there. I think that's excellent. We need more Edge figures, man. I know that they go for a pretty penny here nowadays, but nonetheless, this one looks good. I like everything about it, but that pretty much does it for your Edge Elite figure comparisons. But that pretty much does it for our 2-in-1 Elite Series 83 review on Edge and King Corbin. Guys, thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. I have knocked over the camera like 8 times. I need a new damn tripod. Jesus. But if you guys would like to grab either of these guys, you can go over to ringsidecollectibleswrestlingfigures.com. Use promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10% when shopping over there. Their holiday sale is going on. You definitely want to get in on that, and definitely use that promo code if you're going to shop over there or buy any brand new figures. So definitely do that. I would really appreciate it. Overall thoughts on both figures is they are must grabs. I think the Trash Corbin figure is actually really good. Despite its, you know, its flaws, it's still a really good figure. It's a good updated Trash. I think, you know, everything going on with it actually kind of feels really good in the hand too, which is really weird. You know, I don't like to say that about Corbin, but if it feels good in the hand, man, and when you have a good figure, you just know it. And that's kind of how that figure feels in my hand. I gotta be brutally honest here. And with the Edge figure, despite some slight inaccuracies, the torso's not the best as far as accuracy, of course. Hand tape missing. Rated R logo is not crooked. Chrome shoes are missing. Still a really good figure. Updated Edge. Looks fantastic. We don't have our Ultimate Edition yet, so I say grab it. And you can put them in your pick feds and stuff. I mean, Edge is one of my favorites of all time. Seeing that, man, I am super happy to have it in my collection now. And he'll probably look like that moving forward on MDT. So that's another thing. You got Rated RKO in the house. Can't wait to see what they look like. But anyways, guys, that is going to do it for the 2-in-1 review of Elite 83 Edge and Corbin. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. Subscribe to the channel. Follow. Oh, wait a minute. We got to get into the random shout-out. Oh, snapsies McGapsies. So the shout-out is going to go to Yo It's Extra. He says, that Buzz Lightyear Seth Rollins is absolutely amazing. Deserves that top spot. He is referring to our ranking customs video from yesterday. If you guys missed that, definitely go check that out. It's not like you didn't know the Buzz Seth Rollins wouldn't be number one anyways, because that custom I'm pretty proud of that one. It's probably one of my favorite customs I've ever done. It's definitely top three all time. But anyways, guys, thank you to Yo It's Extra for the comment. Guys, if you guys would like a shout out in a future video, leave me a random comment down below. Like and subscribe to the channel. Turn on that bell for notifications, and I'm getting the hell out of here, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Don't cross over the line, Brad. Shaking my head. You crossed the line, I bet.